Good morning, my dear students. So in this PPT, I'm going to derive a equation with the help of, that is by force analysis method of a Porter governor. Okay. So already in the first class we studied about the what you mean by Porter governor. Okay, and the working of Porter governor and what is the main importance of Porter governor. Okay. So in this I'm going to derive an equation in well. So if this equation will help in solving the problems. Okay. That is Porter governor in terms of speed and height and the angular speed. Okay. So now so here I drawn the diagram of this Porter governor. So normally what is mean by governor or Porter governor? Governor it is a member or mechanical device which are going to use to regulate or maintain an engine speed of an engine speed, okay, when there is a variation of load takes place in the vehicle. Okay, this is about then a governor. Okay, so if we are going to add a dead weight load at the center, exit the center, then we can call as a Porter governor. Okay, so here we are in examination they may ask you around 10 to 12 mark question. Derive an expression for Porter governor in terms of speed and height with the help of using a force analysis method. Okay, so here I am going to sketch, I am going to draw here Porter governor diagram. So here it normally it consists of what, two balls that is equal and same weight either side of the axis shaft, and it is a central a shaft is connected, it is called as a fixed point for the top, and here lower down it is connected with an engine shaft. Okay, so in between we are going to add a dead weight. Okay, so that is called as a dead weight, and I shown here, and dead weight weight is equal to mg. Okay, so when the engine shaft is rotated, so right hand side I am going to draw the free body diagram of half of that. Okay, so when if you start an engine speed, okay, if you start the engine speed, as the engine speed high increases, the rotation of the ball will be increases in the upward direction, that is out, that is a outward direction. So I shown here this one, this side. So during the rotation force will be generated that to outward, that is called as a controlling force or centrifugal force, that is equal to m omega square r. So m is nothing but mass of the ball, and w is an angular speed, r is a radius of rotation. Okay, so here at the right hand side we shown the height, that is from the center point of the mass of the ball to top, that is a height, that is a pivoted point, that is denoted taken as h, and the from there to here the mass of the ball inclination angle is assumed as an alpha angle, and at the same time lower arm we are going to consider as an a beta angle. Okay, so during the rotation of the ball there will be tension will be created both the arm, that is upper arm and lower arm. Upper arm we are going to consider as a t1, and the lower arm we are going to consider as a t2. Okay, so here during the rotation of the ball there is a centrifugal force will be generated towards the outward direction. Okay, so we are going to take on that is fc is equal to m omega square r. Okay, so here there is a force, there is a centrifuge, that is a downward, there is a gravitational force will be there, that is equal to weight is equal to mg. Okay, so this is about the block diagram of this Porter governor. Okay, so now I am going to calculate the t1 value, t2 value, substitute, we are going to get the equation. Okay, so here what are the notation we are going to use in a Porter governor is so small m is the mass of the fly ball, that is a governor ball, or as you can call as a simply a ball. Okay, capital M is a mass of the slew in kg, don't make confuse, small m is a mass of the ball, capital M is a mass of the slew in kg. Okay, so weight is equal to small w is equal to weight of the each ball, that is in mg in newton. Okay, capital W is equal to weight of the dead load, we are going to add the that is the axis of the center of the shaft, so that is in VAM, capital MG. Okay, don't make confuse here, small w is the weight of the ball, capital W is the weight of the sleeve. Okay, so R is the radius of rotation of the ball, how much you are going to rotate the ball from the axis of the spindle, that distance you are considered as a radius of the R. Okay, now height of the governor is already shown in the diagram, that is height is given directly, we are going to consider while solving the problem. Okay, so capital N is an equilibrium speed, that is in RPM, rotation per minute. Okay, that is the revolution per minute. Okay, so f suffix c, that is called as a centrifugal force, which is equal to m omega square r. M is the mass of the ball, omega is equal to angular speed, that is a rotation speed, r is a radius of rotation, radius. Okay, so t1 that is nothing but tension in the upper arm, that is in newton, and t2 is the tension in the lower arm. Okay, these are the notation we are going to use while solving the Porter governor derivation. Okay, so now so again same continuation, that is alpha is equal to the upper arm the axis of the shaft, that is the inclination angle, we are going to consider as an angle of alpha. Okay, so similarly we are going to consider the downward angle, that is the lower arm within the axis of the shaft, consider as in a beta, that is called the inclination of lower arm to the vertical. Okay, so W is equal to angular speed of the rotation, don't make confuse here, going to get the three different W's, that is a small W is the weight of the ball, one more W is an angular speed of the rotation, and the capital W is equal to weight of the ball. Okay, so this is about the notations and the block diagram explanation. Okay, now I am going to tell you about how we are going to derive the equations. Okay, the force acting on a point E, that is called as an our hinge, or it is called an a hinge point. There are four three forces will be acting, that is in half of the center load, that will be equal to capital W by 2. Not we are going to consider the only half diagram, so hence we are considering as W by 2. That otherwise if you are going to consider the full bigger means, we are going to take only the capital W, but we are going to consider only half, so 1 by 2 will be there, so into W. Okay. And tension in 2-2 will be generated in the lower arm and reaction of the hinge. Okay, so there will be always, where there is a tension, there will be always a reaction will be there. So that is also a we are going to consider here. Okay, resolve the forces vertically. Look at the diagram. So resolve the forces vertically. We are going to get the two vertical forces, that is the W by 2, one is downward, and this will be generated in the lower arm T2 cos beta. Okay, from this we are going to get the T2 is equal to, just to replace from W to that side, we are going to get W by 2 cos beta. I give you question number 1. So already now we are going to calculate the what T2 value. T2 is equal to W by 2 cos beta. Okay, now so similarly from this the ball is in equilibrium condition under the following four forces. Okay, the any of the either left hand side or right hand side, the ball should be is in equilibrium condition. These are the forces should be acted on the ball. Okay, that is a tension in the upper arm, that is called as a T1. Similarly, tension in the lower arm, that is T2, and the centrifugal force Fc, and weight of the ball W. Okay, so these are the four forces which will be acted if the ball should be in equilibrium forces. Okay, now going to resolve the forces vertically again. T1 cos alpha is equal to T2 cos beta plus angular speed we are going to get. From this T1 is equal to, but T2 is equal to cos beta, omega by 2 is there, so substitute T2 value, we are going to get what? T1 cos alpha is equal to capital W by 2 plus W, equation number 2. So this is about the equation number 2. Okay, now again resolve the forces horizontally. Now we are resolve the forces vertically, now we are going to resolve the forces horizontally. Okay, so T1 sin alpha plus T2 sin beta is equal to centrifugal forces. Again, we are going to, we know that T2 value, put T2 value here. So again, T1 sin alpha plus W by 2 cos beta sin beta is equal to centrifugal force. Again, from you are going to simplify this, T1 sin alpha plus W by 2 here sin by cos beta is equal to tan beta, right? Tan beta is equal to centrifugal force, but T1 is equal to what? W by 2 plus angular speed divided by cos alpha from the equation number 2. So substitute this value in the equation number 1, we are going to get what? Sin alpha is equal to W by 2 plus angular speed whole divided by cos alpha plus this one is right as it is, that is capital W by 2 tan beta is equal to centrifugal force or controlling force. Okay, so again we are going to simplify this, W by 2 plus W into tan alpha. Here we will see here sin by cos is equal to tan, so I wrote here tan alpha is equal to tan alpha plus the capital W by 2 tan beta is equal to controlling force. Okay, so here divide by the tan alpha, so we are going to get what? Both the side we are going to get W by 2 plus W is equal to tan alpha would get cancelled, plus W by 2 tan beta is equal to tan alpha is equal to, so this side centrifugal force or controlling force divided by tan alpha. Okay, so already we know we studied about before solving the problem, tan beta tan alpha is equal to, assume as a constant term, okay, this is about the notation, and from the triangle tan alpha is equal to what? R by H. Okay, these two values substitute in the above equation, what we are going to get? W by 2 plus W plus W by 2k centrifugal force into divided by R by H. Okay, so again we simplify this, W by W plus W by 2 plus W by 2 into k centrifugal force or controlling force divided by R by H. Okay, so again we rearrange this, angular speed W plus W by 2 1 plus k is equal to mr omega square H by R, that R get cancelled. So this is about we are going to get the final equation. Okay, so small W is the weight, so one more W square is equal to angular speed. Okay, so finally we are going to get this height equation is equal to what? W plus W by 2 1 plus K into M omega square, give equation number 3. So this is an equation we are going to get, we are going to analyze, we are going to remember, recall while solving the problem. Okay, so our in terms of if you got the weight is equal to mg, so weight is equal to mg, again m is equal to weight by g, substitute this value in the above equation, we are going to get what? This height is equal to W plus W by 2 1 plus K. Okay, G into W square, that is an angular speed whole square divided by weight, so give equation number 4. Again from the equation number 3, just to rearrange this equation, we are going to get what? W square is equal to M plus capital M by 2 1 plus K whole divided by M G into H. Okay, these are the two equations, 3 and 4 and 5 equations are required while solving the problem. Okay, so again angular speed omega is equal to 2 pi n by 60, this is the normal formula. Again if you substitute in this equation, we are going to get this equation, what? N square is equal to m plus m by 2 1 plus k whole divided by m into 895 h. This is an equation for speed and height in terms of that is of an Porter governor. Okay, so this question is very important. Okay, now so this is about your what Porter governor derivation. Okay, so this is for the conclusion of this Porter governor derivation is we are going to get the two notes, that is the note number 1 and note number 2. Okay, this is the note is required while solving the problem. Okay, so when the length of the arm equal to the length of the link and the point B and the E lies on the same vertical line, then we are going to assume as tan alpha is equal to tan beta. Any one value we are going to assume in the solving the problem. Okay, again k is equal to tan alpha by tan beta is equal to 1. Okay, so you are going to get the equation for n square is equal to what, small m by capital M by small m into 895 into h. So this is the equation we are going to take directly. Okay, so when the length of an arm equal to the length of the link. Okay, so point B and E lies on the same vertical line. Okay, so note number 2, if the friction force is added to the slew, then the equation becomes changes n square is equal to w plus or minus f divided by 2 1 plus k w into g by omega square. Okay, so this is about the two equation we are going to get the while solving the problem. Okay, so if the speed is increases, use positive sign, that is an n2. If the speed is decreases, use negative sign of n1. Okay, so this is about the derivation of Porter governor, very important while solving the problems. Okay, I hope you understand this. Thank you.